In this video, let us see few of the microcontroller instructions and their addressing modes and how to write comments for those instructions. So here there are few instructions. Let us see all of them one by one. The first instruction, move a comma hash 24. The comment for this instruction will be load the immediate value 24H into accumulator. Here we are moving the data value 24H into accumulator. The data which has to be stored in the accumulator is given directly in the instruction. Therefore, this is immediate addressing mode. Second one, move R1 comma 31H. Here there is no hash symbol, so it indicates that this 31H is not a data value, hence it is a address of memory location. So therefore we are copying the contents of the memory location 31H into R1. Therefore the comment will be copy the contents of memory location 31H into R1. So because here we are using register, we can say that this is register addressing mode. Next one, move R4 comma hash 60H. Here the hash symbol indicates that the value 60H is to be copied into register R4. So therefore the comment will be load the immediate value 60H into register R4. Here again, because we are using register, this addressing mode is register addressing mode. Next one, move a comma 50H. Again here there is no hash symbol, therefore in this instruction we are copying the contents of this memory location 50H into accumulator. So I can write the comment as copy the contents of memory location 50H into accumulator. Here we are using the memory location to access the data, so therefore this comes under direct addressing mode. Next one, move R2 comma 07. That is, we are copying the contents from the location 07 to R2. But here H is not specified. That means 07 is a value of the memory location or the address of the memory location which is given in decimal. So therefore, we will write the comment as copy the contents of memory location 07 decimal. So in the brackets we write D into register R2. Here again we are using register, so therefore the addressing mode for this will be register addressing mode. Next one, move R6 comma hash 7FH. The symbol hash here indicates that this 7F is a data value. So we want to copy the data value 7F into register R6. So therefore the comment will be load the immediate value data value 7FH into register. Here the register is R6. Again we are using register, so here the addressing mode will be register addressing mode. Then next one, move R0 comma A. That is, we want to copy the contents of accumulator into register R0. So this I can call it as register addressing mode, as we are copying into the register R0 from another register A. The next one, move A comma R1. We are copying the data from the register R1 to A. Always the source is written at the end. Here R1 is the source, A is the destination. That is, we are copying from R1 to A. Likewise, in every instruction, we always write the source at the end of the instruction. For example, here in the previous example instruction, the source is A. The source register is A. We are copying from A to R0 and not from R0 to A. So, for this move A comma R1, the comment will be the meaning of the instruction or the interpretation of the instruction can be written as copy the contents of register R1 into accumulator. Again here this is a register addressing mode. Next one, move B comma hash 35H. Again we have a hash symbol here, so therefore this 35 is a data value given which is being copied into register B. So therefore we write the comment as load the immediate value. Here the data value given is 35. Load the immediate value 35H into the register B. Hence this is register addressing mode. Next one, move A comma at the rate R0. This at the rate symbol indicates that this addressing mode is an indirect addressing mode. That is, we will access the data indirectly by copying the data into some memory location and then storing that memory location into some register. So here we store the data at some memory location and that memory location we store in R0. So we always refer that the contents of the location that are stored in R0 are to be moved. So I will write the comment as copy the contents of the memory location which is stored in R0 into accumulator. Here whenever we are using indirect addressing mode, we can use only two registers, either R0 or R1. We cannot use the registers R2 to R7 for indirect addressing mode. For indirect addressing mode, we use only R0 and R1. Then next instruction, move 35H comma A. Here the source is A and the destination is 35. That is, we are copying the data from register A to memory location 35. So therefore the comment would be copy the data from accumulator into the memory location which is 35H. So here we are using the memory location. So therefore I can write it as direct addressing mode. Next one, here move B comma at the rate R0. This is also again indirect addressing mode. This can also be written as, I will change the instruction, comma B. That is, the source is B, register B, and the destination is the memory location which is stored in R0. So we write the comment as copy the contents of, one second, copy the contents of register B into the memory location. The memory location is stored in R0. So therefore memory location stored in the register R0. So this is how we can write the comments or interpret the instructions as well as identify the addressing modes for the instructions. These comments are nothing but they tell you what the particular given instruction will do or what is the meaning of the given instruction, how the instruction will be executed.